out at your party. I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain.
What's good, y'all? It's your boy H-Degree702. You already know what to do. Back here with another video. In today's video, we're here with Strut Vegas, my dad, and we're doing his shoe collection updated version. So yeah, let's get into it. We'll see you with the shoes.
Strut Vegas back at you, jack of all trades. Today we've got something for you here totally different than what I have for you on my last video. This is my shoe collection. This is something I've been working back towards probably since about 2011, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I got. So here we go. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about my shoe collection, some of my personal favorites and what I've been collecting over the years. From the top, I like Jordan's ones. Then we go into threes, fours, and then jump all the way to 11s. Those are pretty much my four main groups of what I've been collecting. I've had other stuff, fives and sixes. The pair Jordan fives were actually the first pair of shoes I got when I started playing basketball as a kid. My first job in high school was at Just for Feet, for you guys old school Vegas cats, Just for Feet on Sahara and Decatur, between Decatur and Artville. That was my first job. So that's kind of what sparked my flame for starting to collect shoes on top of playing basketball. So let's get right into it here with the Jordan 1s. If you want to pan over to the other side so we can see the front side of the shoes. I just got some of, you know, your real classics. I got the Royals when those came back out a couple of years ago. I got the Game Royals. Shadows, one of my personal favorites. Ended up copping three pairs of the Bread Toes. I let go of one of them, but I still got two of these. One of my very, very, very favorites. The OG Defiant. These are pretty cool. Got lucky enough to cop a pair of those. You're all the way back home. Classic, very first Jordan band. This is not the band version, but this is just the Jordan Bread. So this is probably one of my favorite shoes of all time. Great quality on the shoe. Love the colorway. You know, weren't supposed to have that much black and red on the shoe, and actually got fined for it originally back in the days. Ending it off with the Fearless, the women's Fearless Jordan 1 that just came out. Just a good price point on it. Wasn't too big of a blowout right off the release, so I went ahead and gave it a shot. Jordan 3s, got your fire red 3. That's a a really, really nice shoe. Not too expensive if you're looking for something, a classic three that's not too expensive. You can find these for a pretty decent price online. Got lucky enough to get the Tinkers on the release. They released a couple times, but just something about that old school Nike swoosh. I really do like the shoe. Nothing too crazy, but almost like the Fire Red, but just with, you know, with the Nike sign on it. True Blues, another classic colorway for threes. Got a couple pairs of those. And then, obviously, your cements. This is my favorite three. And then another three here, which I can't even remember the name of these. Sport Blues. There you go. And then fours. Threes and fours, real similar shoe. I like fours a little bit better. I don't like balling in the four simply for the fact that the rear toe tab, if you wear short socks like me a lot, tends to cause a cause an irritation on your Achilles tendon, which will cut, rub, irritate. But Fire Red fours, military fours. We got the premium fours. This was a really, really nice release. Great quality leather. It's got the cowhide on the inner. A little bit overpriced in my opinion, but a very nice shoe. And you're not gonna get your money back on it if you spent more than retail. White cements, classic, classic shoe. Can't never go wrong with these. One of my personal favorites from, what was this, like 2014? Green Glow Fours. I love this colorway. Just something about gray shoes always does it for me. But this is one of my very, very favorite fours of all time. Another cool shoe, the Laser Four. This wasn't a big hit, but I got a couple pairs of these, and I was actually lucky enough to get one of the pairs where some of them had Michael Jordan's face on the toe, and I actually got one of those in one of my pairs. If you can see, you can see his face here. So felt pretty lucky. I actually bought three pairs of these, rocked one, sold one, and then ended up keeping these dead stock just because, you know, the face thing's kind of cool. One of my favorites, Fire Red 4. These ones just real hit right off the jump. They went up to like $400 or $500. I think they're sitting around $350 right now if I had to guess, but just love the colorway. Great, it's great with your UNLV gear, you know, just another classic kick. Jordan 11, I mean, there's not much more you can say about this than that. This is what sparked a lot of flame for a lot of people out there. This is one of my favorite shoes of all time, still to this day. Obviously, you can see I probably have more 11s than any other shoe, but yeah, let's just get right into it. The one that started it all, Jordan Concord, they just re-released that with the 45 on the back. Doesn't bother me, you know, because I want something with the fresh sole, you know, and that nice sticky fresh gum sole that, you know, just crystal clear. You love that, gotta love that, love this shoe. Doubled up on almost all these pairs you're seeing here. Space Jams, the re-release of the Space Jam, great quality. This was one of my favorite shoes of all time, hands down, still is. Just love, love, love the shoe. Love the movie. The box is super, super cool on these. It's got the Bugs Bunny 23 on the top. Just everything about this shoe is quality to me at the price point. And had to cop two of those. Also had to cop two of the 72 and 10s just for the fact that, you know, that was a moment in history for us. Is Bulls fans, not Bulls fans, watching it. It was something special, so. And I like what they did with the shoe, you know, a little bit of shine and shimmer in it, but still kept it classy. Carolinas, another classic shoe. I usually don't go for all whites, but this shoe is, you know, the epitome of Michael Jordan in his college career at North Carolina. So had to have that. What were these called again?
Those are the Like 82s, when Like 82s.
Correct. Yeah, these are Like 82s. They're pretty slick. Not crazy about them, but just had to have them. Another one of my favorite shoes of all time, Jordan 11 Pantone.
That is my favorite shoe of all time.
And yeah, just the baby blue all the way around. I love baby blue in shoes, and the quality on this is superb. Real nice suede here, and all around just real classic shoe. Never thought they'd actually come out with this colorway, because you saw a lot of fakes back in the day, but they did actually drop that in a pack. You're literally paying $500 for the shoe, for this shoe. The other is like a Jordan 23. It's pretty much a dud. So whether you pay for the pack or you pay for the shoe, you're going to pay $500 pretty much. But I kept them both dead stock. What I think they should have done personally was put these two in this pack. You know, the Columbias and then the Pantones. I think that would have been a really, really cool touch if they would have kind of done something, a pack with two 11s in it, which they haven't done yet. But I'm no Tinker Hatfield. I'm just a guy out here collecting shoes. So, Derek Jeters. These are slick, all suede, low tops. There is a high top of these. It's a really, really rare shoe. I don't have the money for that, but I did get these for retail, so I decided to cop. Infrared 11s, I've had these for a while. These are another classic low top. I love these. And yeah. Like 96s. A lot of people did some customs of these early and Nike decided to go ahead and pull the trigger on these. I think these are really, really clean though. Love the all red colorway. And then the Concord Lows. I got those back in the day, two pairs of those. And you know, you can't go wrong with these. These are really, really a great summer shoe, something to rock in the summer with some shorts and just kill the game. Moving right on into my Vans collection. I've been really getting back more into my Vans a lot, you know, just simple shoes. That was really when I was in fourth or fifth grade, my mom bought me a pair of Vans, and that was kind of like the first nice pair of shoes I got that weren't like, what were those, like Spaldings or the ones you got at Payless? Yeah, XJ9000s, you know. So yeah, I got a nice pair of Vans. Vans are inexpensive but classy, so let's get right into those. Ralph Steadman's. Ralph Steadman is a classic artist design. He did like an animal pack, so I decided to go with the lions, meaning that I love lions. Really, really cool high top in that Vans skate high. Checker slips, never go wrong with these all day long. Just a comfortable shoe, classic colorway.
Yes, sir.
Harry Potter Slytherin Vans edition. I just like the snake skin. Not a Harry Potter fan by any means in any particular matter. If you are great, no offense, but I just really like the shoe. The Slytherin, the snake style, just a clean, clean shoe. Thought it was creative, just, I don't know, something different. Moving right into the Sinners Club pack. This was a pack that released from Feature Sneaker Boutique out in Vegas, where I'm from originally. And they released this last year, and I obviously had to have them, being like, they're, this version is based kind of like on a strip club version, so they're all suede. Plush, you can see the female silhouette on the front. There's money signs on the inside. Different color van logo on the back. These are really, really cool. They're actually re-releasing their second edition soon here at SneakerCon. Unfortunately, it will only be released at SneakerCon in, I think it's San Diego or somewhere in California. But I'm gonna have to figure out a way to get that pack. That pack is based on a neon light, the Vegas neon lights theme. So they're a little bit more bright and flashy. I think they're super, super rad. So just another classic Vans. I found it like,
Kohl's.
Yeah, just a classic colorway that'll go great with all my Raiders gear. And can't beat that. I had to have the SpongeBob pack. These are just, I just love SpongeBob plus Vans all in all. So that was a must have for me. And just caught the Nightmare Before Christmas as well. A little flashy.
Look at the detail on these.
These are really cool. A lot of detail on those. Both the sneakers are different. But this is one of the ones I really liked. So I like a lot of the more flashy stuff. This was right up my alley. Now we're looking at pretty much, this row is just kind of some random stuff that I held on to just for one reason or another. This is the Calvin Johnson from when he broke the record back, I can't remember what year it was. I want to say it was like 2015, 2016, but cool shoe. Has that full Air Max bubble all the way around the front. You know, you don't really see, I haven't seen anybody else who has these, but then I also got the socks with them. the Megatron socks. So, yeah, just to kind of something different, you know, who knows? Might bust them out one day. These are just some dunks. I was gonna die just to do like an acid wash test on these, but nothing class, nothing crazy, just a classy Levi style shoe. Kate, what the KDs? This is like one of the first raffles I won back when I got these shoes from, this is like right on my birthday. So these shoes were like special for me because like I barely ever won any raffles. And I finally came up on these somehow. And yeah, I was just super stoked. And they're a cool shoe. Both the shoes are completely different. So just really cool shoes. Lightweight. Jordan Future, this is pretty much a gym shoe for me. They just took this the mid and the sole of the 11 and put like a knit cross weave on it. Comfortable shoe though, great shoe for the gym, lightweight. I love it, you know, nothing special. Jordan 5 Green Bean. This is one of my favorite Jordan 5s of all time. It's not really a popular one, but it's full reflective, 3M. Just a really cool colorway. Like I said, I like gray, so the gray with the lime green to me is really cool. It's an older shoe. I want to say this released like in 2005 or something. I can't remember exactly, but it's definitely an older shoe. As you can see, the sole starting to yellow. Probably should just go ahead and throw these on for you pretty soon. And 3Lab 5s. These were hot when they came out. Kind of price heavy, but never really took off in the as far as the value. So I just kind of held on to them. I think I overpaid. I think I paid like $350 for them, but I really like the elephant print. That was one of my favorite things. It's a bulkier shoe though, just holding the Green Bean to this. This shoe is a lot heavier, but it's a really cool look to it. Probably not that comfortable, but who knows. Moving right on to my Air Max section. Most of my Air Max I rock. I don't really stock a lot of them, but these are just some of the ones I either had two pairs of, like the Air Max ones, or I've just held on to them. Starting right off with the Stussy 95s. These are kind of a quiet release. Nobody really talked about these, but Stussy collab with Nike, and they made a black, a blue, and I want to say there was one more color, but I love Stussy as a kid, and so I had to have these. I love Air Max 95. Done deal. I think we're in front of somebody's thing here, so we're gonna have to move. One of my favorite Air Max of all time, the Air Max Atmos. You can't really beat the colorway on this with the elephant print and teal. I got this when they re-released it for Air Max Day. This is probably like one of my favorite Air Maxes of all time. The other ones I like would be the Warhawks, but those are super hard to find in my size and they're pretty pricey. And the Air Max Atmos with the, I can't remember the other colorway. It's like a forest green camo colorway. Sketch the Shelf. These just dropped not too long ago, but it's kind of like the original sketch of the Air Max that Tinker had popped off. I think they're pretty cool. I wanted the black ones, but they sold out and ended up getting the white ones. Air Max Day, Air Max One. I got two pairs of these. I trashed the other ones, so I'm holding on to these. I'm not crazy about the way the shape is of them, but still a classic shoe. And the Air Max Dave White Rabbit. Like I said, I just like the silhouette of the shoe. The color's pretty cool. Okay. Special shoes in my heart just because of when I got them, how I got them, and not any specific reason, just kind of really like some of these shoes. Starting off with this one, Jordan 1 Off-White UNC. So I love these shoes when they originally came out. Me and Isaiah were actually in New York and I wanted to cop the Chicagos when they first dropped and I didn't do it, and I'm sad I didn't because now they're way, way too expensive. So instead of copping those, I sold my Dornbecker 4s and my second pair of Dornbecker 8s because I had two pairs of these, and then I got this pair. So this is a special pair on my heart, and I just think Virgil Abloh killed it with, you know, all the detail on the shoe. And it's just a great, great, great shoe in my opinion. I just really, really dig the quality of it, you know, and the overall concept. And then, yeah, this Jordan 8, had two pairs of these and sold one with, when I also sold my Dornbecker 4s, which I wish I wouldn't have done, but you live and you learn. If there's one pair of shoes I wish I wouldn't have sold, it was my two pairs. There's my Dornbecker 4s and my Kobe 1s. I should have never sold those. But you live and you learn. Moving on, I don't do a lot of designer shoes, but I really was digging these Louis with all the monogram colors on them when I went into Louis one day. So I pulled the plug on these bad boys. Plus it's kind of just like a classic Van style shoe with much, much higher quality on it. So, I mean, you got the black, blue, silver, and the brown. So you've got four different silhouettes of the Louis monogram on these. These are like a classic favorite for me. Slam Dunk 6. This shoe is based off of a Japanese anime called Slam Dunk It. Really rare shoe. A lot of people don't even know about it. Got it from a guy named Jeremy Lamb that used to get a bunch of really cool shoes for me back in the day, then kind of just disappeared out of nowhere. I don't know where he went, but lucky enough to get this shoe, and this is a really cool shoe. In the actual reflection, you can see there's the anime cartoon characters in there, which is a really, really cool feature, I think. But yeah, one of the rare shoes I have, I think. You know, it's not one of the highest valued, but not a lot of people even know about this shoe. Moving on, Patrick Moore K1Xs. These are just really cool. You saw, got these at Feature Sneaker. They only released like, I can't remember, but it's a low number. I want to say like 1,100 pairs of each color in this shoe. It's just something really different. The whole design of the shoe, got a kind of funky thing on the toe box and a cover on the actual shoelaces, and just something really different, and I really liked it, so I went ahead and pulled the plug. This is another release, the Saucony Vegas Chips. Classic sneaker release that only released at Feature, and I think it's a really cool shoe and very comfortable because I've always wore Sauconys to run in. But yeah, great little cop. I think these are the Saucony Pumpkins is what they're calling them. And last but not least in this row, this is a sneaker that I got from a custom designer, independent designer, black owned designer, guy named Delvin Carter, FBCC, which is now converted into SIA, Somewhere in America brand. Check this guy out, man. SIA Collective, I think, is his tag on Instagram, or FBCC Bay Area, but he designs a lot of really cool sneakers. This one is a triple white version that he did, and it's got Stingray on the tongue here. This is Python, and then I believe this is Ostrich on the main tongue, but just a high quality shoe. The whole heel glows. He doesn't only do shoes, he actually does clothing as well. So I'm supporting him. He's a independent guy. I think he's an ex-Navy, but he's done a ton of custom shoes. That's where I first started watching, was just watching his customs, and then he started off his own clothing line. So I'm supporting the guy, man. Check him out. Okay, this is a pack to me that was another dear one to my heart. You got the Fear pack, you got the 5s, the 4s, and you got the 3s. This pack came out, this is back in the good old days, man. This is when you had to camp out to get shoes. There was no raffles. There was no online anything.
No StockX.
If you want no StockX, you know, none of that. It was pretty much, if you wanted the shoe, you went there and you sat there for, you know, 12 to to 16 hours, you know, depending when they would let you actually start to sit there and you got the shoes. I was walking, crazy story. So I was walking into the Caesars Forum Shops. I was a little late on this drop and I was walking down the row and I heard somebody say, "Strut, strut." I look over, it's my boy Drew Down. He's the second one in line, okay? That's how I got these shoes. I walked right over to him, sat there the rest of the time to wait, and boom, got all three of these shoes. But these shoes were at one point each going for almost $500 a piece. The Fear 4s were going for probably around $750 tops, but this is just another pack that's true to my heart. I'm never gonna sell them just because the story of how I got them. And just one of those things, like, you know, crazy how I got them and it just brings back memories. So yeah, these one of the ones I'm not gonna sell. Moving right along, I just got these Stranger Things Blazer 2 upside down. So these are all white. When you start to mess with them, scratch them, sand them down, they're gonna turn into like a blue Levi's color. So I just really am digging them because I like Stranger Things and I don't have a pair of blazers, so I cop these. All red fives. I don't know how these even got over here, but hey, cool shoe. You know, a lot of people like these because they look close to the Raging Bull, a little bit different, but heck, if this is your budget Raging Bull, if you don't want to drop $600 on the single pair of shoes. CP3 Holmes 13s. This is my only pair of 13s I've got, besides one I'm going to show you here in a second. Just like the colorway. LeBron Scooby-Doo's. Didn't really ever take off, but I like Scooby-Doo cartoons, so I copped the shoe. A little bit bigger than I liked for a nine and a half. LeBron sometimes kind of run large, I figured out. I've been running into, you know, not the biggest fan of the Yeezys, but yeah, I do have a couple Yeezys, you know. The Zebras, paid way too much for these, got them high before they re-released them and then they lost all their value. But I still love the colorway, you know, just a classic colorway. Beluga 2.0s, this is probably my favorite colorway of all time. I just, like I said, the gray does it for me, all gray. Just really, really like this shoe. Sesames. Nothing too special about those. Just got them for retail, so I got them. Cloud Whites, just got these. These I also got for retail, so I just copped. 750 Triple Blacks. Story about these. My mom won these in a raffle in Vegas. She took Isaiah in to buy some, they bought some Lakers gear or something. She put the raffle in for me. She hit, boom. So this is another pair that I've actually rocked these a couple times, but I'll never sell these either. Love this shoe. Got two pairs of the Statics. This is the first release. They came with the see-through inner where you can see your sock on the inside and stuff. I thought they were pretty cool. Got lucky enough to get two pairs. And the Yeezy, what are these, frozen yellows or whatever they call
them? Semi-frozen.
Semi-frozens. They're pretty slick, just something loud. Like I said, sometimes I like loud sneaks. I just bust these out for vacation sometime just to keep it loud. And just a couple more surprises I got for you guys here. These are just a couple shoes that I pulled out that I had like way back in the day when I first kind of started getting into it. These are the Gucci Air Force Ones. So I got the material and then I actually had a guy come in and make these for me at a shoe shop back in Vegas. He was like, "I don't know if I can do it and blah, 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 and this and that," but they turned out all right for just a, you know, my first little custom dealio. They're kind of beat now. And then these ones, these are my Jordan 13s. These are like the very, very first pair of shoes, Jordans I bought for myself back in 1997 when I was working at Just for Feet. So I've held on to these for like a long ass time and they need a complete redo of everything, but they're more like a sentimental shoe for me just because, you know, that's the first pair of J's that I really bought for myself. Yeah, all the other stuff I had when I was a kid, I ended up throwing away. So if you really care about your shoes, it's probably not gonna be ever the same it used to be back then because those were like original shoes and stuff, but you know, keep your shoes, man. Take care of your shoes. Use your sole crap, use your shoe cleaners, do what you gotta do. But yeah, try to take care of your shoes, man. And that's pretty much all I got for you guys. Strut Vegas with a little collection piece. And you know, this is it for me.
All right, guys, it's been your boy Ace Degree here with my dad, Strev Vegas. That's it for the shoe collection video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. Stay tuned for my next video, and we'll see you later.
All right, Strev Vegas out.